welcome to the third and final part of the Space Wolves Stormfang Gunship painting tutorial. Now in this part we're going to finish the model off. So I'm going to be showing you how to complete the canopy, then how to paint a blue glowing effect on the gun, then a glowing effect on the runes as well, and then finally we're going to do all the pack markings too. Now even though we're painting this particular model for this video, the techniques and advice are useful for all sorts of miniatures in the Space Wolf range, so no matter what you're painting, you'll find something useful in this video. Now the end's nearly in sight for this model, so let's get it finished. I'm going to start out by painting the canopy bars, and I'll do these in the same colour scheme as the rest of the hull. So that means I'm going to be starting with the fang. I'm going to be using a detail brush to apply this, and well, the most important thing here really is to be as neat as you possibly can be. So thin your paint down a little bit, and make sure you don't have too much of the paint on your brush. Get a good fine tip. Now the bars on the canopy are raised in a kind of a relief from the rest of the plastic, so you can use the side of your brush to just gently paint that raised surface. This way, so you can avoid getting the paint on the recessed plastic of the window. Now, doing this, well, you can still see some of the plastic through it, so you will need to do more than one layer of this. Two or three should be just fine. Really take your time with it to avoid getting any paint where you don't want it. Now, if you do happen to make any mistakes, it's not a problem because we've not undercoated this component. So what you can do is just use your fingernail to scrape the excess paint away, though obviously the less you have to do this, the better. Once you've got a good solid base coat, we can move on to the first layer paint, which is going to be rust grey, and this again is the main armour colour of Space Wolves. So you're going to be applying it in the same way as what we've just done with the base coat. So get your paint ready, and you only need to thin it down a little bit, and as before, make sure you don't have too much paint on your brush. And I'm going to be applying this in just the same manner. So once again, using the side of the brush and being as neat as I can throughout the whole thing. Now I've finished the rust grey, I've also just taken a few minutes just to go all around the edge of the canopy with some Agrax Earthshade where it meets the hull, just to help it blend in. And with that done, all that remains is to highlight it. Now, we can't highlight this in the same way as we did the hull and dry brush it because that would be too messy. So instead I'm going to do an edge highlight using Fenrisian Grey. Now for this you're going to need a fine detail brush, and it's very important that you get your paint prepared on your palette. So thin it down a little bit, and make sure you don't have too much on your brush and that you've got a good tip on it. And when you're ready, what you need to do is angle your brush so that you can catch the corners of the canopy just around the areas here. So use the side of your brush and just gently run it down, and you'll get a thin, lighter line just running along the corner there. So you need to do this around all these main corners on the canopy. So around these parts here and down the sides there as well. Just take your time with this, be as neat as you can. And with that edge highlight done, the canopy is now finished, and you can see it really blends in with the rest of the hull around it. And now we can move on to what really is one of the unique features on this model, and that's the glow on the main cannon on all the pipes on it. Now for this we're going to start out with a base coat of Calidor Sky, and I'm going to be applying it using a standard brush. So just use your palette once again to get your paint ready, and you're looking to do a base coat on all the parts that you want to have the blue glow. There's a great picture on the side of the box which shows you all of the different pipes that are blue, but you just need to spot them and then paint them completely with this colour. So now the base coat's done, we can move on to really building up the colour. So the next colour that you're going to need is Temple Guard Blue, and this we're going to apply it very thinly. So using a standard brush again, when you put the paint onto your palette, just water it down a little bit more than you normally would. Just mix it together and get a good thin colour on your palette. Now the trick here is to make sure you don't have too much of the paint on your brush at once so that you don't lose control of it. So use your palette to get rid of the excess and then start painting it over the blue pipes that you've base coated so far. So you see when I'm putting this on, you can still see that Calidor Sky through it, which is perfect because even though you're covering most of this, it means that when you add a second layer, the extra paint you put on will be even brighter. So you can build up a stronger colour in the middle. So for this stage you want to put this thin layer over all these blue areas that you've just done, and then once it's dry we'll add a second layer and make the colour brighter towards the middle. So now the first layer is dry, I'm going to add a second. So applying the paint in the same way, but this time focusing it just slightly more towards the middle. And you can see this new layer I'm putting on is a much brighter blue, and it's really starting to build up that glow effect. So once this is dry, well, you can really add more layers, as many as you want to, really. Just keep on going until you're happy with the brighter blue towards the middle. I've added one more thin layer, and you can see now we're building up a really nice bright colour. And what we're going to do now is, well, carry on this, but this time we're going to be using Baharoth Blue to make it even brighter. So I'm going to be using a detail brush now, and you need to prepare your paint in the same way as we did earlier. So thinning it down a little bit more than usual, then making sure I haven't got too much on the brush. And when you're ready, you just need to paint this onto the pipes again. Now, once again, we're looking to aim a bit more towards the middle, but also now we're aiming it more on top as well. So when you're looking straight down from the model, you want it to be brighter. So on the top pipe, that means painting up to about that distance down the side. But on these smaller pipes down here, you're looking at this kind of area here, just like that. Now, as before, we're just going to do a few thin layers of this. So about two or three should be perfect. Now I've painted three thin layers just to really build up to that nice bright colour, and there's only one more colour left to do. So now you need some white scar, and we're going to be applying this, well, once again in the same kind of way, but this time I'm using a fine detail brush. So again, get your paint on your palette and thin it down a bit more than you normally would, and then just make sure you haven't got too much of the paint on your brush. And when you're ready, you're looking to apply this again, just slightly more towards the middle and focusing it on the top. So just a small amount, kind of in this middle area here. So you're looking at all towards the top, so just round here, and the same goes for these larger pipes here too. There's also just on here. And once it's dry, add a second thin layer just to build up to a nice pure white just in the middle. So now I've built up that white to a really bright colour in the middle, and well, now I'm really pleased with the result. Now, doing this technique does require a bit of practice to get right, so it's worth having a go on some spare plastic or even on a bit of sprue before you try it on your actual model. But you can see it's really worth it, and it's a very useful technique to know. And now we're going to move on to painting the runes, and these require the same four colours. So we're going to be starting out with a base coat of Kalador Sky, and then we'll layer it using Temple Guard Blue. But after that, we're going to use Baharoth Blue again, but with an edge highlight this time. And then finally, we're going to use White Scar, once again edge highlighting it. But with Kalador Sky, we're going to start out with a fine detail brush right from the beginning. So when you're getting on your palette, thin it down, just like you were doing before, so it's quite watery. But that's for a different reason this time. That's because we're going to be painting it into the runes. And if the paint's quite thin, it runs in very easily. So get a good tip on your brush. And then just start working around the runes all across the model, painting this colour directly into the recess. And this is just to build up a good strong colour for later. Now there are quite a lot of runes around the miniature, so you've got these that run down the main gun, but also there's some on the sponsons and on the engine housings too. So just take your time. You might need one or two layers of this blue to get a really strong colour, but build it up and then we can move on. Once the base coat's dry, the next stage is to layer using Temple Guard Blue. I'm using the fine detail brush again, and I've thinned the paint down just like when we were doing the pipes earlier. So as I paint it on here, it runs into the recess. But also, whilst you're doing this, you need to allow some of the paint to run either side of the pattern. So this is going to create the glow effect. And because the paint's so thin, as it dries, it'll blend down on that black beneath it. So just take your time and always follow the shape of the pattern. Now I've finished the Temple Guard Blue, you can see there's a stronger colour in the recess of the rune and a softer colour going around the edge of it. The next stage is to use Baharoth Blue to do an edge highlight on these shapes. So you're looking to do the corner going around all the way around the edge of the runes. And the final step is to just add a small edge highlight with white scar just on all the corners of the pattern. So little areas like this corner here, and then around the edges around here as well. And with that last edge highlight done, the glow on the runes on the gun, and on the sponsons, and the engine too, are now complete. And now we can move on to the final thing that I'm going to show you how to do in this tutorial, and that's the squad markings. Now, this Stormfang's going to be for some Wolf Guard, so the pattern's going to be yellow and black. But if yours is going to be for a different squad, then you'll want to change the colours here. But the actual technique for doing this tooth pattern is just the same. Now, the easiest way to do it is to break it down into a couple of stages. The first is to mark out where the pattern's going to be. Secondly, you connect these dots. Then finally, you just fill in the rest of the pattern. So to start out, you need some Abaddon Black and a fine detail brush. And get the paint ready on your palette by thinning it down with a bit of water so that it flows a bit easier. And get a good tip on your brush. So what you need to do is look carefully at the box art, and then around here on the model you'll see that the actual pattern interacts with the shape of the engine coverings at certain points. So if you can spot what those are, like here for example, they give you good points to start building the pattern from. So the one up here is almost on that corner, and then these two will have one in the middle of them on the opposite side, just over there. So you see, you need to repeat this process all the way around the engine covering, so take your time with it, and keep referencing the box art all the way through. The next step is to connect these dots. So once again, with your fine detail brush and some Abaddon Black, thin down and with a fine tip on your brush, you just need to start painting lines to join them. Now, I find the easiest way to do this is to angle the model so that you're painting towards yourself and downwards. That way you can get a nice straight line like that. If you do make any mistakes though, don't worry about it. You can always neaten up with a bit of Avalan Sunset. And finally, all that remains for the pattern is to fill it in using some Abaddon Black and a detail brush just to complete it. Now, whilst you're doing this, you will at points have to go over some of the edge highlights you did on the yellow earlier, such as along there. And once you've done those, just re-edge highlight that with some Eshin Grey. Now, once this is done, you can add some transfers if you want to. And for an in-depth guide on doing transfers, then check out part 4 of the Imperial Knight painting tutorial. And after that, well, you just need to base it and do it in the same way as the rest of your army. Now that I've finished the squad markings and added some great company transfers, the Stormfang is now complete, and I'm really happy with how it's come out. Now, just to recap, when you're painting the canopy on your miniature, be as neat as you can, and I know I often say it, but it's especially important on that part because you can't repaint over any mistakes. If you do make any mistakes though, then you can always scratch the paint away with your fingernail, and I recommend that over using an actual tool so that you don't scratch the plastic. And when you're doing the glow effect, remember to thin your paints down so that you can build up a gradual transition of colour. And when you're doing the squad markings, well, it's easiest if you break it down to a couple of stages, mark it out, and then fill in the pattern afterwards. Now, this video has been lots of fun to make, so I hope you find it useful with your Stormfang and all of your other Space Wolf vehicles too. I'll see you next time for some more tutorials.